Hello, welcome to my channel. Today I'm not doing any painting or any drawing, any sort of art, but today I'll be explaining about different watercolor supplies and I'll be suggesting you the best watercolor supplies to buy if you're starting your watercolor journey. So let's start with brushes. Generally there are two types of brushes, flat and round. I mostly prefer round brushes and I'm doing my painting with round brushes since long. If you're starting your watercolor journey, if you're a beginner, what I will suggest you is that don't buy that much brushes, only few, like one round brush, one flat brush, few thin brushes. I usually don't use flat brushes, so this is the flat one. It's from Camlin. This is the thickest one I have. This is my most favorite and I use it like almost in every painting because it is very useful to cover large areas. This one is also my favorite. It is not that thick, not that thin, and it is perfect to cover medium areas. These both brushes, I mean. This is the thinnest one and also it's my favorite. This is also, it's very useful. It's from Camlin. And this is very old brush. I don't use it often, but yeah, I do have it. So these are the brushes I'll recommend a beginner to buy. Now let's come to papers. So here today I'll be talking about two different kinds of paper. First is drawing book. If you are absolutely new to watercolor painting, I recommend you to buy these drawing book first. So this drawing book do have these wheel charts at the back of it, so you can just go and learn it. It will give you knowledge about primary, secondary and tertiary colors. So first buy these drawing books, practice, and when you feel that you are confident enough, so you can go ahead and buy watercolor papers. So what is the difference between these two kinds of paper? The quality of paper you get in drawing book is very thin as compared to watercolor papers. So let's talk about watercolor papers. So the watercolor paper I use is this one, the Canson one, and I do buy it online from Amazon. If possible, I'll put the link in the description. So the watercolor papers are very thick. I do have a drawing, I need to complete that. Okay, so watercolor papers are very thick and they help your colors to blend properly, and these are very useful if you're a beginner. I'll recommend you to buy these, like first obviously practice in drawing book and then buy this, and you do get 20 plus like 8 sheets free, which is nice and it is quite reasonable also. Now let's talk about colors. There are different kinds of colors such as watercolors, poster colors, acrylic, liquid watercolors, watercolor tubes, but I'll show you what I use. So I use this Camel Artist watercolor cakes. It has 24 shades and it has a free brush with it, which is my absolute favorite. Sorry for this mess. And this is my absolute favorite. If you are a beginner, I do recommend you to buy this. And the MRP is, I think, 300 rupees. So this is the watercolor cake I use. At the back of the packaging, you do have the names of the shades. Now next, what I use is poster colors. Most of the time, I use watercolors and poster colors. These two colors are my favorite. But this is very old and so this is not the actual shade of it because I have mixed my old colors in it. So these are the two poster color boxes if you wish to buy. These are watercolor tubes. I don't use it that much. These are acrylic paints. They are mostly used to paint surfaces like glass, etc. But I don't use it that much. The next essential that you will need is masking tape. This masking tapes don't work on normal drawing paper, so use it on watercolor paper. A clean cloth and a palette, you'll get it for like 20-30 rupees. So these are the supplies that I'll recommend: Camel Artist watercolor cakes, Camel poster colors, brushes, a clean cloth, palette, masking tape, and watercolor paper. If you liked this video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe to my channel, and comment down below. Thank you so much for watching.